Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about how much insulation you need in your attic. The short answer is, we generally recommend 6 inches of open cell. Now obviously it gets a little bit more complicated than that. Now you'll probably hear a lot of people say, well, you need 12 inches of cellulose in your attic, or you need at least a foot of fiberglass in your attic. If you ask 6 people this question, you'll get 7 answers. There's a lot of ways to do this. Here's why we recommend 6 inches of spray foam, specifically open cell spray foam, in your attic. With any insulation, but specifically spray foam, there is a diminishing return value. So once you get to a certain depth, you do not really get any more perceptible value as far as heat retention, as far as air seal. However, your cost will continue to go up as you add inches of foam. So 6 inches is really the sweet spot, the perfect place for an attic where you can stop heat loss, you've established an air seal, and that's a good value. Now, if someone is recommending 12 inches or more of foam or any material like that, I would question it. They may have a valid point given your specific situation, but I would definitely question it. Now, as far as cellulose and fiberglass, people say you need that much depth. Now, if you want to stop heat effectively, you will probably need 12 inches or more of cellulose or fiberglass. Now, one thing to keep in mind is, over time, you will need to add to that fiberglass or cellulose. You know, if you have fiberglass or cellulose on the floor of your attic, it's going to break down over time. So you're going to need to add to that. So if you're just blankly asking someone, you know, how much insulation do you have in your attic? And they say, oh, I have 2 feet in there. That's not uncommon, because again, over years, they've probably had to add to it. You know, there's a couple other things to keep in mind as well. It's not just about how much insulation is in your attic. If you have a traditional material like fiberglass or cellulose, you will also need to have venting put in. You will also need to maintain that material. So when you get drafts in your attic because you have vents, it's going to want to move that material. So if you look in an attic that hasn't been touched, let's say in 5-6 years, if you go up in your attic, you may notice that the cellulose and fiberglass has shifted and it's really waved up onto the sides of your attic, and it may not make sense to you. That's because air comes in, and just like sand dunes, it's going to carry that material and bank it up on the walls and different areas of your attic. So you will need to maintain it. You're going to have to get up in there and re-rake it, make sure it's level, as well as making sure those vents are in place and cleared and not obstructed or damaged. So again, how much insulation do you need in your attic? Generally speaking, we say 6 inches of open cell spray foam in almost any residential attic will be sufficient. Any more than that, to be honest, you're usually wasting money. Any less than that, well, you're probably not getting as much heat protection as you should. If you have any questions about this, please let us know. If you're not sure what you should put in your attic, or if you think you have a certain situation that may be a little bit different, let us know. Tell us about it. We'd love to help you out. Be sure to like this video. Subscribe to our channel. We have all kinds of videos going over attic insulation. And don't forget to smash that bell so you see all of our notifications. And that's how the foam's applied. Oh, excuse me. Professor of Foam here. How can I warm you up?